present value and future value. We're going to look at defining future value and present value. Future value is the amount of an investment or loan at some point in the future. The problems that we've worked so far have been present value. Today we have $250, we invest it, and in a certain amount of time, for example 4 years, what will that amount grow into? What is its future value? Versus present value, which is an unknown value that we want to calculate. And the definition of present value is the value of an investment or loan at the very beginning of its life. This number is also called the principal. We may have a goal in this example of attaining $500 in a period of 3 years. What do we need today with the terms and conditions to make that a reality? That's the types of problems that we'll be looking at in this section. So how does one compute a present value? We're going to use a table, very similar to what we did for calculating compound interest. We will use a present value table where we will take our future value, our goal, and multiply it by a value from the table. Here is a present value table. We have N representing the number of compounding periods in the investment, and that's what this first column is. And similar to future value, we also need to calculate what I, the annual interest rate divided by the number of compounding periods per year, that I value is represented here in each one of these columns. So let's see how this works. In this first example, we're given a person estimates she will need $18,500 to buy a new car 4 years from now. The $18,500 is a future value. The question is asking us how much must be invested now at 4% compounded annually to have the needed funds. In other words, what's the present value? We need to calculate the interest rate per compounding period. It's 4% compounded annually, so we take 4% divided by 1 will give us our 4%, which will put us over here in this column. We need to further calculate our N, the number of compounding periods. The frequency is annually, so that's once per year for 4 years, gives us an N of 4. So we're looking for where that row intersects the 4%, and here we have our multiplier. To calculate the present value then, we will take our future value, our goal, $18,500, multiply it by the value from the table, 0.85480. And so today, for this to become a reality 4 years from now, the $18,500, we would need to have deposited in an account $15,813.80. Let's look at another example. A business estimates that they will need $275,000 2 years from now. How much must be invested now, the present value, at 6% compounded quarterly to have the needed funds? We need to calculate our interest rate per compounding period. The interest rate is 6%. It's being compounded quarterly. If you take 6% divided by 4, we get the 1.5%. We next need to calculate how many compounding periods there will be. Quarterly means 4 per year times 2 years. 4 times 2 means we have an N value of 8. Here's those calculations shown here. 6% divided by 4 is the 1.5% for your I and your N. 2 years times 4 times per year for quarterly gives us 8. Where those two intersect, we'll use that value times our future value, in this case $275,000, to arrive at the present value. For the $275,000 future value in 2 years to be a reality, we would need to have $244,120.25 today, present value. One more. Jenna wishes to start her own daycare business in 4 years and estimates that she will need $25,000 to do so. What lump sum should be invested today at 5% compounded semi-annually to produce the needed amount? The $25,000 is our future value. We have 4 years to accomplish this. We have our interest rate that's being compounded semi-annually. They're asking us what lump sum is needed today. We're looking for the present value. When we use our present value table, we need to calculate I, the interest rate per period. So we'll take our 5% divided by 2, 2 because of the compounding semi-annually, twice a year, to give us an RI value. Next, we need to calculate our N, how many compounding periods will occur during this time frame. We have a 4-year term compounded semi-annually, so 4 times twice per year gives us an 8. We will look up the value from the table from the intersection of these two numbers that we've calculated. You should find 0.82075 is the intersection of our I and our N value. Multiply it by the future value to give us the goal or the present value to arrive at that goal, $20,518.75.